And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Bactrosaurus, which was a request from Patrick via Patreon, so thanks. It was a hadrosauroid that lived in the Cretaceous in what is now China, and its name means club lizard. The name refers to the club-shaped neural spines on some of the vertebrae. It was described by Charles W. Gilmore in 1933, and it's one of the earliest known hadrosauroids from Asia. Gilmore had found 6 specimens in a bone bed. This included skull fragments and postcranial fossils, including limbs and pelvis, have been found from at least 12 individuals, both juveniles and adults, in this bone bed.
Nice.
Yeah. The type species is Bactrosaurus johnsoni. There's another species, Bactrosaurus kysylumensis, which is also known as Cionodon kysylumensis, but that's a dubious genus based on partial fragments. It was described by Edward Drinker Cope in 1874.
He named a lot of dubious genera.
Yeah. There's also a third species, Bactrosaurus prynadai, which was originally Tanius prynadai, but not many bones have been found. Bactrosaurus is about 20 feet or 6 meters long and weighed about 2,400 to 3,300 pounds, or 1.1 to 1.5 tons. Originally, it was thought not to have a crest, but a later study found what looks like the base of a crest in early development that was partially preserved. A 2003 study found evidence of tumors, both benign and cancerous ones, in Bactrosaurus skeletons, and they may have been because of environmental factors or genetic.
So they were caused by something.
Yes. And Bactrosaurus couldn't do anything about it.
Well, yeah, that's for sure. It's hard to treat tumors without thumbs.
That's a good point.
And probably without hands.
It might have had hands. Hadrosauroid?
Yeah, maybe. I was just thinking, you know, over 2,000 pounds, getting into need four leg kind of territory.
Mm.
But it's hard to say. Could have had those weird hands that also have, like, hooves on them.